Giving unto Almighty God, this minister Laura Spate, all my brothers and sisters in Christ, I thank you for the support, and I just want to thank for all the new supporters and the new friends. And I'm just thinking about how the world as a whole, how we have gotten, it is so wicked, and just people have just came over to their own mind. And I'm reminded of James, where it says the fervent and effectual prayer of a righteous man availeth much. And I just wanted to, and I said in one of my posts, I said, well, you know what? I said, we have all kind of events, but why can't we have worldwide altar calls and city altar calls to bring people back? See, we need to really step up our game as prayer. And the Lord laid on my heart just that I need to do a prayer. And I want you brothers and sisters, everyone, I want to say everyone that's my friend on Facebook, I want you to come in agreement, because I'm a living witness that prayer changes things. See, we're in such a bad way. When do you know that someone will take your life for any amount of money? They don't even have to know you, but if somebody gives them the right price, they'll take your life. That's the evil that has just came upon. Our children are getting shot down in the streets, and babies put in trash cans and book bags and just all kinds of things, just killing people for Social Security checks and going in nursing homes, and we see our patients are being, our loved ones being abused and sexually molested, impregnating disabled children and people that can't help themselves. Oh, brothers and sisters, we have just got in a bad state. And I just want all of my brothers and sisters, because the Lord laid on my heart that I need to do a prayer. And I want you to go in agreement with me. If we can't have worldwide altar calls, let's use our freedom of speech on Facebook to do something positive. So I ask you, brothers and sisters, if you pray with me as we give the world back to the Lord, because only until we do that, we got to understand that prayer changes things, and that the fervent, effectual prayer of a righteous man availeth much. And so I'm just asking you, brothers and sisters, to go in agreement with me right now. Pray as I pray. Pray with me. Pray for me. And we're going to go to the throne of God, and we're going to give it all we have, to lay down everything, to stop what you're doing, and go in prayer with me. Eternal God in heaven, Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we come realizing that you are God all by yourself. Lord, we come right now leaning and depending on you right now, Lord. We're asking you right now to have your way, Lord. Father God, we know that people have turned from you, Lord. But we're coming right now, Lord, to stand in the gaps, Lord, for that liar, that whoremonger, Lord, that backbiter, that backslider. Lord, we come right now, Lord, asking you to have mercy right now, Lord. Lord, we need you to come see about your people right now, Lord. Father God, we come realizing that it's a wicked generation, Lord. We know Satan is busy, Lord, but we know that you are a bigger God, Father God. And if we call on you right now, Lord, Father God, we just know that you can do all things but fail. Right now, we're asking right now, Lord, to bind together, Lord. Be that glue, Lord, to put families back together, Lord. To mend marriages right now, Lord. To bring brothers and sisters together, fathers and sons, mothers and daughters, Father God. Father God, let us not get so caught up on which doctrine is superior, Lord. It's all about Jesus and him crucified, the death, burial, and the resurrection. Lord, I'm come standing in the gaps right now, Lord. We need you right now, sweet master. We can do nothing without you, Lord. We come depending on you, Lord, realizing that you have never failed us, Lord. We can call you in the midnight hour, in the noonday, Lord, that you have a line that's never busy. Lord, come see about your people right now, Lord. Lord, come right now, Lord. See about your children right now, Lord. Be a fence around them, Lord, right now, Lord. We ask you right now, Lord, have the leaders to stand up, Lord, and to speak your word right now, Father God, to worship you in spirit and in truth right now, Lord. Lord, I thank thank you, Lord, that you laid on my heart, Lord, that we got to come back to the altar right now, Lord. We got to leave our burdens down, Lord, and we got to stand in the gaps right now, Father God. Lord, we asking right now for the ones that don't know you, Lord. We ask you right now to shake them up, Lord, and let them know that you are real, Lord, and that you're nothing to play with, Lord. We come realizing all kinds of things, Lord. Man has just turned his heart, Lord. The heart is hard like Pharaoh, Lord. But Lord, we're asking you right now, Lord, the same God that said, peace be still to the sea, Lord. The one that's parted the Red Sea, Lord. The ones that feed a multitude, Lord. Lord, the one that healed the sick and raised the dead, Lord. We come right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus right now, Lord. Lord, there's no other help we know, Lord. If we could turn our back on you, Lord, where could we go, Lord, but to the Lord. Lord, we come right now. We're asking you right now to see about your people, Lord. Lord, there is a need right now, Lord. You know our neighboring countries, Lord. They want us to worship you, Lord. We're asking you right now to open up your storehouse of heaven right now. Lord, give them the resources that they need to worship you, Lord. Lord, somebody need to know that you are real and you are God right now, Lord. That you are the one that performed miracles, Lord. And Father God, we come right now asking you right now, Lord, to touch us right now. Lord, realizing that you will never leave us nor forsake us, Lord. We're asking you right now to bind the enemy right now. Bind anything that's not like you, Lord. Anything that stands in our way, Lord, to worship you in spirit and in truth, Lord. We need you, sweet master, Lord. We can do nothing without you, Lord. Father God, we need you right now, Lord. People are dying on operating tables right now, Lord. People are being shot down in the streets right now, Lord. Father God, we got a president that don't seem to be about nothing but his own agenda, Lord. But you are in charge, Lord. Come realizing, Lord, it's not about Democrat or Republican, Lord, but it's all about you, Lord. It's all about Jesus and him crucified. Lord, come have your way right now, Lord. We need you, sweet master, right now. We can do nothing without you, Lord. We come right now realizing that you own the cattle of a thousand hill, Lord. And Father God, that all riches belong to you, Lord. Come see about your people right now, Lord. We need you, sweet master. And I'm interceding right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus right now, Lord. Lord, let my voice go to heaven right now, Lord. This is a serious thing right now, Lord, that I'm committed until I die, Lord, to serve you, Lord, and to tell somebody about the good news of the gospel right now, Lord, by any means necessary, Lord. Does somebody need to know you right now? Lord, somebody will be turned around. Lord, somebody will be saved. Somebody will be delivered right now in the name of Jesus right now, Lord. Lord, I know my brothers and sisters, Lord, they're walking in unity, Lord. We're praying in unity right now, Lord. Come see about us right now, Lord. We can do nothing without you, Lord. Get a power back to the churches right now, Lord. Father God, you said that to much is given, much is required, Lord. Let us go in, Lord, and be the men and women that you've called us to be in these last and evil days, Lord. We can do nothing without you, Lord. And we come right now, Lord, thanking you for everything that you have done, Lord. Realizing that if you've done nothing else, you've already given us more than we deserve. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for your blessing, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for the ones that want to know you, Lord. I thank you for your laborers, Lord. Lord, you said the harvest is great, but the laborers are few, Lord. Lord, we're bringing people in, Lord. Help us to be the change we want to see in the world, Lord. Father God, we know, Lord, that Satan is a defeated foe, Lord. And we want to thank you for that, Lord. Help us to stand right now, Lord. And we thank you for the whole armor of God, Lord, that we may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Have your way right now, Lord. In the name of Jesus right now, Lord. Lord, I'm being obedient, Lord. You told me to do this, Lord. And I walk, Lord, in your ways, Lord. And I'm going to serve you until I can't serve you anymore. And Lord, I'm pleading and I'm begging right now, Lord, that our people be about your business, Lord, because that's all that matters in these last and evil days. Lord, have us to go back to the altar, Lord, to renew our power, Lord, to go and plug into our power source, Lord, knowing that it is you, Lord, because you said in your power we can remove mountains, and they got to move. Lord, that we can remove storms, Lord. And they got to cease right now, Lord. We're asking right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus right now, Lord. Have your way right now, Lord. If you would do this and hear these prayers, Lord. And we thank you, Lord, for the blood of Jesus that goes to the highest mountain and to the lowest valleys. Lord, and we come right now, Lord, realizing that Jesus' blood must not, will not suffer loss, Lord. If you would hear these prayers, Lord, we're interceding right now, Lord. If you would hear these prayers, Lord, we'll be so careful to give you the honor and the glory that we're justified, unified, satisfied, unified, sanctified in the name of Jesus. Now have your way, Lord. Lord, we ask that these prayers go to heaven right now, Lord. And have your way right now, Lord. If you would do this, we'll be so careful to give you the honor and the glory. In the names above all names, it's so worthy to be praised. In your son Jesus' name we pray. Amen and thank you, God. I want to thank you, brothers and sisters. I just came from Bible study, and the Lord just, he told me that I had to just reach out. Because there's a falling away. But God need his people to stand in the gaps. Because the fervent, effectual prayer of a righteous man availeth much. And I take God at his word. And I know you, brothers and sisters, you take God at his word. Help us to pray, Lord. Help us to be the men and women that you've called us to be. Lord, help us right now. Lord, we need you. And Lord, I feel the power of our brothers and sisters, Lord, as we go in unity, Lord. We have the power because you gave it to us. Lord, help us to have that Pentecost power, Lord. As Peter preached, Lord, that people will be transformed. Lord, people are going to churches. They're caught up in emotions. But Lord, where's the deliverance? Where's the transformation, Lord? Where's deliverance? Where's restoration right now, Lord? We can't go into church and come out the same way that we went in. We're missing something, Father God. Help us to know and take hold of what Christ died to give us. But I thank you. And Lord, I just want to walk in obedience. And I thank you, Lord. And I want to be the change that I want to see in this world. And Lord, I'm thanking you for sending federal laborers. Lord, I thank you for the sister that says, I'm encouraged, and she started a ministry. Because we need laborers. Lord, lift her up right now, Lord. Help her right now, Lord. Lord, we need your help because we just can't make it. We tried and tried again, but we can't make it without you, Lord. And we need more on the battlefield. Some no-nonsense soldiers, Lord. Some kingdom seekers, not churchgoers, but some kingdom seekers that want to worship you in spirit and in truth. Lord, have your way right now, Lord. Have your way. We give it all to you, Lord. Because we know that you're coming back for a church without spot or blemish. And Lord, I thank you that you gave us the power to do this and to tell someone that you are coming back. And I thank you for the power of the righteous. Because you said in your word, if the righteous scarcely make it in, what will happen to the sinner man? We got to be about your business. It's too many people playing games, setting up GoMe funds, pretending people are dying so they can get money. Lord, I know you're going to deal with all of that. Lord, if there's a need, Lord, you are a God of abundance. You are a God of prosperity. Lord, and I know if it's about you, Lord, you will bless it. But these folks that think it's a mockery and want to use the name of Jesus just to make money, Lord. Lord, have mercy on their soul, Lord. And if they don't turn from their wicked ways, Lord, I know they got a reserved seat in hell. Somebody need to know that God ain't playing. They need to read the Old Testament. How God, we are under grace and not the law. But God, it's bad to be turned in the hand of an angry God. And there's accountability for what you do. And Lord, have mercy on the souls of the one that misuse God's name and try to get rich. You don't have to do that. Because if you trust and lean on God, he gives you what you need. And he's so good that he give you some of what you want. But I thank you, brothers and sisters, because I feel the unity. And I can see it on the page. And I thank each and every one of you that we come together. And we pray and we bear each other's burdens. But my burden now is for souls to be saved. Because we're losing people. And people have been turned over to their own pleasure. The problem is, we're me-centric. It's all about me. I got mine and you get yours. But that's not how the Lord wanted to be. So we have to bear each other's burden, lift each other up. And my prayer goes for the one that just don't know you for the free pardon of the sin. When you call on God, make sure you're ready to follow him and forsake all. Because we have to deny ourselves to follow God. That's the problem with us. We want our cake and eat it too. We want God's blessing, but we don't want to walk in obedience. We can't give up what we want, our pleasures, but we want God to bless us anyway. Oh, I'm here to tell you, that ain't how it works, brothers and sisters. No. Either you worship him, he's the God of all, or he's not God at all. There's no happy medium. You got to deny yourself and walk in the ways of the Lord. If you're going to be a follower, you need to count the cost. Because you got to be into it for the long haul. No turning back. Be ready to follow him into the end. Jesus died for you. If he died for you, you should be willing to live for him. I just don't understand those type of things. But if you think you're doing things on your own and you don't need Jesus, I tell you what. If you think that you don't need Jesus and that you running your own life, I tell you what, make yourself live forever. Never leave this earth. If you really think that it's all about you and you're in control, make your body never get cancer, never get diabetes, never get hypertension. If you really think that you're running things and that God is not controlling your life, I challenge you to live your life disease free, never have a trial or a tribulation. I'm talking real here, folks. I'm just being real. For folks that don't think God exists and they think they're doing things on their own, make your world trouble free, sickness free. Make yourself rich if you can do it all by yourself. That's my challenge to you. But see, I know that everything I have come from God. See, I'm not that foolish. I'm not that smart to know that I think I can do things on my own. I'm not that smart. But God has been good to me. And I know that I don't look like what I've been through. I'm a living witness. If you seek his face and put him before everything, God will take care of you. But he led me that I needed to do a worldwide prayer. And I thank you, brothers and sisters. May the peace of Jesus continue to be with you. Minister Laura Spate, remember, visit my twin ministries, my YouTube. For God be the glory, because I'm nothing without God. And I'll worship him until I die. But I just want to talk for a little while. The fervent, effectual prayer of a righteous man availeth much. And we need to go back to the altar. And give God back his land. Because the devil is defeated. What he need to be doing is sucking on a Maalox bottle. Because his fate is sealed. But I thank each and every one of you for listening. And may God be the glory. I thank you for your support. May God bless each and every one of you. And the peace of Jesus be with you. God bless you.